Hello dear friends, welcome to Shiksha Mantra once again. Actually getting tired of the problem in our live streaming in YouTube. Finally I have decided that it's better to make some short videos regarding the magic in English grammar and put it so that you can learn from this. You can watch those videos without any buffering. So now we are going to discuss our topic that we have started to discuss in our live streaming, but it failed. The topic is whether who is used as the subject or object when it's used as indefinite pronoun. So here our discussion is on indefinite pronoun. So here our discussion is on interrogative pronoun. So what do we think of interrogative pronoun? When we discuss of interrogative pronouns, normally I would discuss on the personal pronouns that is used for persons, because the problem lies there. We use who for subject, whom for object, and whose for possessive. So these are the three different interrogative pronouns that we use: who for the subject, whom for object, and whose for possessive. Actually, there's no problem regarding whose, because whose is always used for possessive. There's also no problem regarding whom, because this is also used for objective only. But what's about who? This is used for subject, but could we use this for object? If I ask you a question, it would be clear. The question is, who are you watching? Who are you watching? So your answer would be, I'm watching Shiksha Mantra. So you are watching Shiksha Mantra. That is your answer. So here it clearly says that for who, the answer is Shiksha Mantra, and which is the object of this verb. So here, who is replaced with an object. So who comes in object position. Now if we consider the interrogative sentence, who are you watching? Here you can very easily find out that you is the subject, are watching, that's the verb, and the conjugation is with the subject you. That's why who is also used here as object. So that's how we can use who for object in interrogative sentences. So when who is a with an interrogative pronoun, we can use this as an object as well. So besides being subjective, this is also objective. So this is what we need to remember, this is what we need to learn, and here we may add some other points as well. Here we have taken a sentence, mom is talking to the maid. So how can we form questions by using interrogative pronouns here, and our target is to the maid, okay? That would be asked. So we may write, who is mom talking to? So this is question number one. Here we have used who for object. This is object, and here who is used as an object. Now if we can use who as an object, where is the need for whom? Why should we have whom as the objective interrogative pronoun? We may use who only. So why is there whom? There's also reason. You may ask the same question as, whom is mom? Whom is mom talking to? So here you have used whom as the objective interrogative pronouns. And dear friends, we have another option here. Check it out. There's the third option, to whom is mom talking. So here this two, the proposition has been brought at the beginning of the sentence. So we started it as, to whom Is mom talking? So here we are also using whom as interrogative pronoun. But here you must remember that when you are placing the pronoun at the beginning of the sentence, at the beginning of the question, when you start it with the preposition, you can't use who here. Here you'd have to use whom, to whom, and you can't say to who. So this is what we need to learn and we need to remember regarding interrogative pronouns and the use of who as both subject and object here. So that's all for today. We'd call the show here off. And obviously, you'd find out some new magic in English grammar here in Shiksha Mantra in the show. So keep watching, keep glued to our channel. And if you have stumbled upon this channel for the first time, now you'd have to press the subscribe button with the bell icon on and obviously accepting all the notifications so that you get the notifications first. So that's all for today. We are coming, we're returning with fresh videos very recently. So till then, bye bye.